Welcome to another Ghostbusters Afterlife unboxing video. Today, we are going to be taking a look at one of the bigger things in my Ghostbusters collection. Now this released over a year ago, but the Ghostbusters Afterlife Plasma Series Ecto-1. This thing is huge. Look at it on my shelf. I mean, usually I try to keep this out of camera because I gotta take that off my wall. Man, it's just so big, I kind of need to have it there. But so we'll take this away for a second. I actually did some updates to my background. So now I have been getting these mini Puff Surprise fairly regularly, but I haven't gotten them all at once. I've gotten one here and there. I figured, well, it doesn't matter. It doesn't make sense just to do a video on one of them, which is why I had done it with the Stay Puffed initially. Yeah, and then you also notice the name patches over there. Those are new because I got a new Ghostbusters flight suit. And those are the extra ones, so I put them up there. And it works out because I want to be a Spangler for Halloween. To go see Ghostbusters Afterlife. So those are just a few things you'll notice. Also, Muncher is missing. He goes right here. He's out in my dining room for a reference. More on that another time. But anyway, so on to the actual video. I've been looking forward to this thing. This was a birthday gift, actually. But I've been looking to get this thing. I was kind of skeptic when they released it. I remember I was actually in the car when the stream came on, when they announced it. I was kind of skeptical. I was like, that's expensive. I don't think I'd be able to get that. But here it is. Now I hope I get the not too burnt variant, but the kind of burnt variant, because there's like three stages. There's burnt, not burnt, and then there's in the middle. So my box is a little dinged up. It got dinged up in shipping, but anyway, so on the front it's got the same flight suit design as all the Plasma Series stuff. It says Ecto-1 Plasma Series on there. Now, this is Ghostbusters Afterlife Ecto-1, so just keep that in mind. You'll also notice that because it's in the barn. This artwork is amazing. Probably my favorite Ghostbusters artwork to date. But it's just look how detailed and amazing it is. I mean, come on, that's awesome. And we flip it on the side here, and it has that... can't even really fit it all in. Has the same kind of design that's on all the sides of the Plasma Series figures, the kind of simplified version of the character you're getting, since Ecto-1's like a character, gets a spot too. Now here is the back. So this has a lot of cool features. It's got the gunner seat, opening doors, deployable RTV, which this will be my second RTV, and then it's also got a picture of it right here, and it's got the text, and it says, "Looks like the classic Ecto-1 got a few upgrades. With new features ready to take on bigger, badder ghosts, the ghouls will be running scared." And then on the other side, there's a little diagram, kind of cool. And then on the bottom, licensing, and on the top, just the Ghostbusters logo. So, without further ado, let's open this. I don't have a knife, so I will be right back. Alright, so I have, of course, turned the ring light on. I kind of retired the kitchen pantry pro. I still use it for other things, just not for these. So I got my old Swiss Army knife, Ghostbusters 2016 reference. Alright, so I think this is the top. Alright, so this seems to be the top here. Oh, nice. I didn't get the tuber. Okay, so, it comes, set up kind of funky. There's a bunch of parts that you gotta add on. So, we're gonna take this baggie out and stuff. And put it on the side. And here's the main shell. There's an elastic on it. We'll take that off. Where's my Ghostbusters 2016 Swiss Army knife? You know what, scissors might be better for this. I'm gonna cut it out off camera, but I won't take it out until camera's rolling again, so. Alright, so I cut it out. That took a lot longer than I thought it would, but here she is. And then here's the part of the roof rack. Now, I actually noticed as I was cutting it out, that I think mine is scratched? I'm not entirely sure, but mine does have scratch marks on the top. Yeah, but we'll get to that later, because that's not the focus right now. So, I'm going to assemble it now. Something tells me, didn't see instructions opening this, but I think I'm going to be fine, because I think I have a pretty good understanding of what it's supposed to look like. So I'm just going to assemble it off camera. So, yeah. Alright, so I have completed the Ecto-1. It only took about 2 minutes, but here it is. There it is. Oh, I love this thing so much. It's just beautiful. Really quickly, before we get into the cool things, I just wanted to show this. This is the RTV. This is my second model. So it's probably the smallest one I'm going to get because I know that ornament's pretty expensive. But here's the big one. Look at how much better this one is. It's got the red inside the wheels there. It doesn't look as fat as this one does. So this one, my favorite RTV all the way. It's got the striping, and it even has slightly steerable wheels, and that's pretty cool. This one does not. So I don't know how they did better on this one, but worse on the bigger one. I don't know. But yep. So that's to scale. Now this is if I'm correct, 1/8 scale. Let me check. Which means it's not in scale with the 1/18 scale. My bad. I don't know how I can think that's 1/8. No, it's not in scale with the actual figures themselves. I mean, you can see they're a bit bigger. But they're more in scale with the real Ghostbusters figures. But those are still too big. And I don't even have any of them. But yeah, so let's actually take a look at the Ecto-1. So this is the side with the ladder. Now, of course, we all know that the ladder has switched sides over the course of the past few movies. So this is, you know, the original Hallmark ornament for it. But yeah, the ladder switched sides to make way for the gunner seat and door. So we'll get to that. But I wanted to start on this side because there's just so many details on this, and plus I want to save the gunner seat for last, or almost last. Save the really cool stuff for later. So I'm going to zoom in here, because there's some pretty small details. So, first off, I do want to point out the cracked Ghostbusters logo. I think that looks pretty cool. Now, I actually made a custom of the Ecto-1, and I had gotten a little bit of cracks on it, too. On my initial, this one doesn't have any cracks, but my initial one did. And I actually usually don't keep that on the shelf because it's a custom. I don't usually display customs, especially for Ghostbusters, because they're not official. So, but yeah, so we have the cracked logo, and we also have this amazing rust detail that starts the front and works its way all the way back. I mean, for a $50 toy, this is some pretty, not toy, but for a $50 model, this is some pretty good rusting detail. And it's not even like a solid white. It's like a faded white, like a dirty white, which is amazing. I love that about it. I can zoom back out now. There we go. And then we have like the antennas, which we'll, you know, probably mention again on the other side. And then we have all the roof rack detail, which we'll do later on. And then, you know, the doors do open. This one, I believe, does not. This one does not. The front driver's seat door does. If I could get it to open. I don't even know what to use to open this. Like, where to put my finger. Fingernails are too short. Here. Right here. There we go. So that's how the driver's seat door opens. We can peer in there. We'll cover the inside later on, the rest of the inside. Peer in there. The steering wheel is huge. That's just how it was. And the door detail is actually pretty cool. They have, like, the window cranks, because if you don't know, Cars just have cranks to crank open the windows. That's why they say roll down the window instead of push the button down the window. It's not my camera. Yeah, so they have that detail in there, which is pretty cool. And you can see all the brakes and the gas. There's even some detail in there to see the radio speedometer, which is pretty cool. But so we can close the door. Right there. Okay, we'll turn around to the front, where it has, I guess, the most problems. Zoom out a little bit. Yeah, the front has them. It's just hanging off the shelf. The front has the most problems because it's just kind of a matte paint. It's, you know, not too, like, detailed, and the license plate isn't even rusted. I would customize that, but again, I'm not too one for customizing things, especially really expensive things, and this is, you know, the most expensive thing I have right now. Individually, you know, trying about all the figures, but... So it's pretty expensive to get another one. I don't want to mess up. At worst case scenario, we can make another sticker. But, you know, I'd rather not. Something I actually wish you could do is open the hood. As far as I'm aware, you can't. Yeah, you can't. Because, you know, there's a few screenshots where the hood's actually open, which, you know, my DeLorean's hood open, like my 1/15th scale DeLorean opens. I mean, it's only open for, like, one shot, maybe, if I even made it into the film. But, yeah, so, I mean, the rest of it looks pretty cool. I'm going to mention this all the way around. I do wish they had done more detail with the windows. They don't look too great being just so clean. I wish they had made them dusty. I know that in some of the video clips we had seen, there were broken windows. It would have been cool to see that. Then there's the antenna, the lights. I guess we'll go to the roof rack right now. It doesn't have everything, of course it doesn't. But it does have a lot, and a lot more than my, I think, 1/19th scale, 1/20th scale, remote control Ecto-1 that came out in 2016. It has a lot more detail than that, which is, you know, great. Like, a lot more detail. The tanks look pretty cool. It would have been cool to see some text on them, but, you know, $50, you know, you're not going to get everything. And then there's, like, the hose thing right here, the thing that looks like, I think WD-40 cans. And then there's just a whole bunch. Now this isn't just all, shiny metallic, or not metallic, but shiny detail. There's actually, like, dirt specks on it. And I think this actually has a, I don't know if it's supposed to have that or not, but it has some marks on it, and some scrapes. So that's really cool that they went and did that. And again, back to the front, there's this burnt appearance on the Ecto-1. So I don't know if the whole burnt thing is a key part in the new Ghostbusters movie, or if it's just like weathering. But I'm glad I got this one, and I don't know if that's those scratch marks are supposed to be there. I can touch them up with some weathering powder. I don't think they're supposed to be there. But anyway, onto this side, the cool side. I forgot to mention this before, but the wheels are also the white wall tires. They're also weathered a little bit. They're not clean by any means. They're a little bit dirty, but not too dirty. Kind of wish they were dirtier, but. Not gonna, you know, rate the model based off that. So here's another antenna, and then made of the same plastic as the antenna. I don't know what this is, frankly. I don't know what anything on the roof rack actually does, because I'm, you know, not that hardcore, even though I have at least $300, maybe $400 of Ghostbuster stuff. I'm not too hardcore, and $300, $400 doesn't actually sound like that much compared to some other people, but so then this door, I believe, does open. Yeah, it does. There we go. See inside some more. Bring this closer. See a lot more detail. Some actually really good detail, you know, right there. And I'm still not too, you know, smart with cars or anything. And all the doors do snap right in place, which is excellent, because, you know, now I know that they're closed. And this is where it gets cool. So we'll get that second. So then there's more rust detail, a lot like what we saw on the other side. But here's where it gets pretty cool. You open This is actually open a little bit. You open this door, swings open all the way, that's why there's no ladder there. And then you pull this out. This is my first gunner chair experience. You pull it out, and it swivels around, just like in the clip we saw in the movie. So then you can put your imaginary Phoebe figure there, 1/18 Phoebe figure, and then she can go ghost busting. I realize the Zenmore tag just fell over. But yeah, so that's actually pretty cool. There's actually some detail on this. It does, I think, rotate 360. And there's some pretty cool detail on the gunner seat. We can just... Nice. That's what this camera's got good zoom. I think it started to droop again. Yeah, so this is a pretty good model. I wish it was colored a little more for $50. You know, it doesn't have lights, it doesn't have sounds, it doesn't move. I wish we had gotten a little more detail on the gunner chair and the gunner seat, but whatever. What am I gonna do? I'm of course not gonna customize it, but. So then there's the lights on the cyclotron, I think. That's what they called it. I might just be confusing it with the thing at Gettysburg. Cyclorama. This is a cyclotron. But yeah, so it's got detail. It's not exactly like what we saw with the figures. There's some little changes here and there, but yeah, so that's pretty cool function. You know, it doesn't do it automatically, but actually it's really cool because you can actually see they detailed the mechanism too, which looks really cool. There's a bit of like an orange or a brown tinge to my reflection here, but we will put that back in. I think it's in right. There we go. Just slides right in. I'll set that back down. We will zoom out first. And then we will close the door. There we go. Snap. And then we'll take it around back. So there's just some more detail around the lower part of the model for rust. And then here is the trunk. I will call it the trunk. And that just slides open like that. And now here's where... That can snap right back in. Here's where it gets really detailed. Now the inside is insanely detailed for this model. Like, you can see... Each box is individually hand-painted. Each, like, gizmo piece of machinery or technology is hand-painted. You got all the red knobs, the buttons, everything. Everything is painted. And then even if you look further in, there's an RTV box. Zoom in as much as I can here. There's an RTV box inside. Let's see if it'll focus. There we go. There's a remote trap vehicle box in there. And there's also some more stuff back there. There's the gunner chair again. But yeah, so there's just so much detail in here. It's insane. The biggest nitpick I have about this model is if you look in here, the floor looks to be just lazily painted with just like, you know, a paintbrush they just got in there. They just did a few strokes of a watered down brown paint. That's the biggest flaw I have with this. Not too big of a flaw, but that's the biggest flaw I have with it. And so then, I mean, in my case, actually, before we even close it, we have one more thing we need to do. So the RTV, which is pretty cool, can actually fit. It snaps right in here. There we go. Snaps right in there. Real nice. So, yeah, that's pretty cool. I actually don't have anywhere to put this on my shelf. Okay, so I've noticed my shelf is kind of small. But, because if you remember, I had no real plans to get this. In the first place. But then I saw videos of Apollo, and I thought that was pretty cool. But yeah, so I guess that's everything. I know it's a bit of a long look at this. But I usually go pretty detailed and blabber on. Yeah, so this is my favorite piece of, I don't even want to say it. It's my favorite Ecto-1 model I have. I have a lot. I mean, this was my favorite since I got it. Because, I mean, lights and sounds, but it's also really flippin' detailed. But this is my new favorite. Even though I don't have any room to display it, it's my new favorite. I might try to put it in that corner, but yeah, so I guess that's the unboxing. So you guys can pick up one of these models, I think, on Amazon for $60 right now. Initially, it was $50, but yeah, I think you can probably pick it up on eBay for $60. It has gone up in price because, you know, it's not on shelves. I think it was on shelves for a very brief time, but it hasn't been on shelves for a year now. So we are getting very, very, very close to the movie. Now, this was, of course, recorded long before it was uploaded. So TV spots are just popping up. Getting really excited. We're in the final home stretch. So thank you guys so much for watching this video. You can see Ghostbusters Afterlife in theaters November 18th. Getting very close. So that's the whole unboxing. Thank you guys so much for watching, and remember to stay puffed.